this other stuff was going on while I was opening bookshops and producing records and doing all these other enterprises that I got involved with. So Gordon and I took a break from singing together for 38 years. And we didn't get back together until we were asked to do so by a great friend of mine for a benefit. I'll let him tell you about it.
I guess this was my wife's idea, you know, when she heard I was doing this. Kathy, my wife, said, if you could get Peter and Gordon back together, that would be a real coup for this thing. I said, it's impossible. I made one call to a guy that I've known for years. He said, let me talk to my partner, I'll get back to you.
Paul explained that he had decided to put together a 60s-themed benefit to raise money to provide Mike with what he needed, and asked me what it would take for Gordon and I to get back together for one show. I thought about it really only for a moment and realized that it was would be wrong to say no. So I called Gordon, asked him what he thought, and he shared my view. Clearly there was good reason to do it, no good reason not to do it.
There was no way I wouldn't have done it. I really do share with Peter that, you know, I think Mike is a great, great musician and a great guy.
Called me back the same day. He said, people have been asking us to reunite for the last 37 years, but this one, for Mike Smith, I think we're going to have to do it.
I called him back and said, yes, we'll meet him. So, more than I got back together for the... Thanks. And yes, hooray for Mike Smith. He was a legend. He's back in the so, more than I got back together and did this benefit, and it was fun. People liked it. And we, because of it, got invited to do a number of other shows together. And we started singing together here and there whenever it fit in with all the other stuff I was doing, whenever Gordon felt like doing it, and wherever it would be fun. We ended up doing one on Santa Monica Pier for quite a few thousand people, and that was pretty much the last one we did. And I'm so glad we did those, of course, because Gordon died, you know, not that long afterwards, and we all miss him very much, but I'm so happy that we did get to sing together for those last couple of years. And it must be said that one of the amazing things about Gordon was that even when towards the end, he really wasn't feeling very well, and he was kind of moving slowly. He wasn't someone who looked after himself at all. Indeed, quite the opposite. And he really wasn't feeling great and moved slowly, and sometimes he'd sort of hobble on stage. But his voice remained intact. He had this huge, fantastic, great voice, which was with him till the day he died. He also retained his love for great songs and great songwriters. I'll let him tell you about his very favorite.
Everyone remember Buddy Holly? We decided that we needed a sort of ballady type record to go with our list of songs that we sing. And so we chose this one. Just you know. And you know why, 'cause you and I.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Except the applause and joy of the world, thank you very much, it's fantastic. Thanks so much. I realize I've been rambling on a bit too much. We've overrun a little bit here. But I do, first of all, just want to introduce my fantastic band, without whom none of this would be possible. Over on guitar, Brian Popular. Bill C. Clay on the bass. Steve Aho on the drums. And our musical director of the band, David, Jeff Allen Ross. What we're going to do, actually, by nature of an encore, we will do the one song we left out of the story. You may have noticed we put the lyrics up, we talked about it, but we didn't actually sing it. So I'd like to end the show by asking all of you to sing along and be Gordon, because I just sing the harmony on this one. And then when we, after this song, Ken Dashow is going to come out and we're going to do a quick Q&A if we have time. My apologies for running a little bit beyond. I tend to talk too much once I get going. So there's no excuse, most of you probably know the words anyway, but in case you don't, here they are. So now you've got no excuse not to sing. And here we go with World Without Love. Hang on 1 second while I get my...
So baby, until then.